Maneuverings today in the Pier 34 collapse case. Action News reporter John Rawlins is live on Columbus Boulevard in Philadelphia. John, what happened in court today?
Well, what happened in court today, Jim, is that the defense once again renewed its effort to get rid of or throw out the felony cases in the Pier 34 case. The surprise came when the judge, who had initially rejected the idea at an earlier date, today said he would take several weeks to consider the matter.
Only one Pier 34 defendant was in court today, Michael Asbell. Co-defendant Eli Koretny was absent recovering from a heart attack he apparently suffered following his last court visit 19 days ago. Defense attorneys today argued that the felony charges in this case should be thrown out, that the most serious charge concerning the pier collapse, risking a catastrophe, does not apply because it would require the defendants to have committed certain specific acts, such as using gasoline or explosives. Instead, the defense argued, a lesser misdemeanor of failing to prevent a catastrophe is more appropriate.
The only felony in the case is the risking the catastrophe and the conspiracy, which is hinged to that. So
right.
That's right.
Right.
The rest of the offenses are all misdemeanors, which would mean that we would be entitled to a municipal court trial.
By starting at municipal court, experts say the defense would not have to face a jury over the emotionally charged incident that ended in the death of three young women nearly 2 years ago. The defense would also have an automatic appeal to the Common Pleas Court if there were convictions at municipal court. This scale model of Pier 34 was commissioned by attorney Thomas Klein. He represents the family of one of the victims, Deanne White. No matter what the judge decides in the criminal matter, Klein says, it will not affect the civil case against those involved.
No, not at all. The civil litigation stands on its own. In the civil litigation, there's a wider net and there are completely different theories of liability and a different burden of proof.
Klein says that wider civil net includes a wealthy investor as well as engineers and contracting companies. Back to the criminal issue for a moment, Jim. The DA's office signaled it was confident it would prevail in this challenge. The way it reads the statute, it says the felony charges of risking a catastrophe are appropriate for what happened here in May of 2000 and that it should be up to a jury to decide it. The judge said he would rule on the matter May 22nd. Live at Pier 34, John Rawlins, Channel 6 Action News.
Thank you, John.